Alright, I'm playing Shadow of the Avatar again. Alright, I've done a little bit of levelling up since the last video I uploaded. And now I'm going to attempt I'm going to start doing the Grand Tour to try and get my Christmas hat. In the skills trainer to actually level up. Just review my character right now. So, I'm at level 7. I need 1600 and something to get to level 8. 300 gold, health 71, focus 72. Let's visit the trainer. I've got 8 points to spend. Alright. There's no point in doing that yet since encumbrance isn't in the game. So I did level some of these things up a bit. So I can preserve my armour and not my weapons. That's 3 points. Going for it. Increase my health. Increase my strength. Increase my dexterity. Let's just check what we've got going on here. Focus. Is there anything worth having up here? Nothing I can afford now. So let's just go back and increase my health one more time because that's quite cheap. There we go. That's me leveled up. 76, focus 74. Now let's review. My sword is fairly good. My shoes are good. My leggings are getting done in a bit. That's my light armour. And I've got a torch, which I don't really need to be carrying. In the daylight here. So let's equip my shield. Which also might need repairing soon. Right, so I've only got one repair kit. So the next thing, next order of business is to find the merchant. It should be around here somewhere. Gold. Villager. Wellington. Oh, there he is. There's the merchant. Right, so I want some repair kits. Let's have a look. Recipe, repair kit. He's got loads of them. I can afford three at the minute, so we'll have three. And I'll sell some stuff, because I have a whole load of crap. Yeah, all of it. All of it. Oh, quartz wax. That's worth quite a lot, isn't it? Probably I could use this stuff for crafting. But I'm not into that at the minute. I wonder if I can buy a health potion. I might make a profit on this exchange. Oh, my nightshade, I can sell that. Maybe I can get another repair kit at this rate. Right, let's look at all these rusty swords. One's 90. A few that are 70. So let's sell all the ones that aren't at 70. I just want to keep some spares around. Because you never know. I think if encumbrance was enabled, which basically means I'd be weighed down with all these swords. I'd be discarding them like nobody's business. What else have we got? Spider silk, let's sell that. Okay. Sulfurous ash, let's sell that. Venom sack, okay. So I'm making a profit, which isn't bad. Maybe I can buy a couple more repair kits. If there's anything else, what's that do? But it is better. But I'd need to buy a repair kit just to repair it, wouldn't I? Let's not worry about that now. Let's level up a bit. 5 to 16. Right, 7. Gosh, stack weight 973. Don't understand what those mean. But what I shall do is not buy it. So let's grab a couple more repair kits. Anyway, sign for exchange and then talk to him again and get a couple more. All items. For now, and hold on to my gold. Hopefully, that'll be enough to do this quest. So, here is our tour guide. Good day. Winton's Folly, the Plains of Ryanis, Graph Gem Lines, two places, Owl's Head. Added this to my journal. Let's review my journal while we're at it. I managed to slay a wolf leader twice while I was levelling up, so there you go. So, what I'm going to try and do first is Winton's Folly. This is an interesting one because it's the first desert location. That's the word I call it. Desert biome, I think, is the in term to appear in a game. sort of look quite different to this, the sort of generally grassy areas. Now the risk with doing this one is that I suspect it's a higher level than what I am at, and also there's no naked women shimmering out into existence next to me. Also, there's no road there, as I understand it. So, if you're not walking on the road, there's a risk you get pulled into random encounters. So, we'll see how the random encounters go. If I spend more than 10 minutes doing random encounters, I'll probably just wind up the video and I'll start editing stuff out. So, Winterfell is on the other side of that mountain. So we're going to head that way. Oh, already we're in. We're pulled into a random encounter. They've hardly gone out of the village. Go on. Which one am I targeting? There we go. Spiders are annoying because there's so many of them and they gang up on you. So if you stand still, they all just crowd around and bite you. So what I'm going to do is run back and forwards and thin out the herd a bit. Hopefully not sustaining too much damage myself. Let's pick another spider. Ow. Some copper over there, look. Taking a bit of damage. All that investment in strength and dexterity obviously doing me some good. Next spider. The trick is not to walk in front of them most of the time. And also the trick is not to die while you're killing them all, so you don't even get a chance to loot them. Because obviously, all of this depends on making enough money to buy the repair kits to still steal for a bit. Got attacked by two of them. Move. Alright, let's see if I can just take him now. There's only two of them. Because they're only spiders. That's really valuable. There was one more, wasn't there? See if there's anything else valuable in the undergrowth I can take. Not seeing anything there. I'm looking for sparkly things. Oh, there's some copper here. Yeah, let's do that. Take all. What's this? No. Nothing. That's just grass anyway. Yeah, it's not sparkling, it's just sun dappled. Next question, where's the way out? I don't know what that plus means. Store. Oh, I see. You can buy stuff. Buy stuff right in the game. Escape beyond forest. It's back to the start, isn't it? Oh, I can shut down a tree. I've not done that before. Pine wood. Is that all I got for it? Oh, that was my first tree. Oh, there's a way out. Well, there's a way out. I think it is the way I came in, to be honest. I'm not going to do any more spiders. I'm just going to run away. Escape the forest at least. I can go with a bit of a run on the Hidden Vale Hills. I think this is it. Oh no, there it is. There it is, right. Time to try and get the first tour guide. Before I go in, I'll just check what the state of my gear is. Right, so repair kits repair about 20 damage. Oh look, there's people fighting over there. About 20 damage, so there's no point, oopsie, there's no point repairing anything until such time as you've accrued that much damage. You're just wasting your 100 gold. Let's see what this was. Grey wolf. So I don't know if that's because he didn't bother taking all the animal hide, but let's carry on. I presume that is Winton. And what we're looking for here. Oh. Grey wolf. I don't know how many of them there are. For like an abandoned settlement. It's quite an impressive vista. I said before, you know, I like the. What's the phrase? What's art direction? I don't know if the graphics are really yet up to the standard they're wanting to be at, but I think the you know, the way they lay everything out is very nice. Ooh, skeleton. Thought out. Large skeleton. Now we can take a large skeleton. Take a large skeleton. Oh, lagging. I can't stand and fight him anyway. I can do my running backwards and forwards trick though. Skeleton. Let's try not to attract his attention. So, what have you got? 19 gold and a rusty sword. That stillness, focus cost. Let's just see what that experience was. 70 for a live skeleton. Another one there. I don't know if I have to fight him though. Let's see if I can find this settlement. Guessing I do have to fight him. Giant scorpion. I'm gonna go fight him anyway. apparently is too giant for me. Ah, oh, look at that. He poisoned me and I'm dead. So, what will probably happen at this point is that I'll pause the video and come back and not attempt to fight any giant scorpions. Just stick to the giant skeletons. Right, so we are half an hour in to my little video, and I've not got the first step done yet, which is good to know, and then I start all the way back there. Right. Ooh. Don't really want to see my butt. I can see the tower in the distance there, look. Oh, scorpions. So I've come in a different way, have I? Rolf. Yeah, it certainly seems like it came in a different way. Lots of scorpions. I think they're chasing me. Hopefully they'll get bored. Or they'll attack the wolf or something. Ah, a big cactus. Alright, so basically at this point I'm lost. Let's head over there and hope we don't attract any wildlife attention. Ooh. All right, here's the man. There was a big nasty scorpion around here before. So let's hug that wall. And I'll just run away from the walls. Or maybe they'll chase me and set up on the skeletons. You never know. Interesting. Alright, be warned, this wasn't the optimal route. By any stretch of the imagination. At least I don't appear to be tired from all this running yet. So that gate that I went through. Is it chasing me? No. That gate that I went through. Took me out of the map altogether. So we got him. Backwards and forwards we go. I wonder if we get stronger at night. Okay, what have you dealt with? Ooh. Ectoplasmic residue. Iron longsword. What does that do? 5 to 16. Let's equip that for now. Which repair kits have I got? Alright, it's too dark for me now. I suspect they'll see me coming. Which was the way? That was the way back out. No, that was a tower. So this is the way in. See, the problem with running around doing your backwards or forwards running to kill skeletons. Is that you do end up a bit lost sometimes. So I want to avoid him. If only I could see over. I have a screenshot there. Village. This is probably a bad way to get in with all them skeletons. Skeleton. So let's lag it. The old standby. Is it still chasing me? So basically, I just ran into all of them. Oh look, there we go. Hello. Come on, check in. Cool. Alright, so where was that way out? Out. There it was. There it was, we're running away. We're running away like nobody's business. And we escape. So that wasn't too bad, apart from it took like half an hour to locate the blooming guy. So the next one is, I believe, up the coast. Now the question is, can I get there without without encountering any fatal stick to the path. Veil mark. Nice tallow. What was the place called again? The Plains of Rye Innes. Which I believe. There they are, look. There they are. Let's enter the Plains of Rye Innes. Fighting. Let's have that cotton. Ooh, brown spiders. Skeleton archer. Alright. Head to a rock. And then head left. According to the videos I watched. There he is. Hello. I gained 300 experience from skeleton footman. Cool. Your progress. Graph gem mines, I think, will be a video by itself. Shall we ever get one of these? An archer. Let's do the archer first then. No, let's run away. Let's run away, run away, run away. No, I'm doing two of them. Oh, that copper though. came in. Spider calibrated in the copper. Interesting. And spiders. I don't know what they're like. But then they're like scorpions. Probably not good for me. So, I'm just going to trot on over to Owl's Head. Back to the village and use the roads from there and avoid the random encounters. Oh, I didn't avoid the random encounters. Let's see what happens. Go and attack him then. There we go. There's lots of them. They don't appear to be too high level though. I should make, since they're skeletons, I should make a serious amount of gold out of this. That was a whole gang of them now, look. Skeletons. Let's pause this for a screenshot. Takes a few hits. Considerably now. Right, that's of course it's my new sword, isn't it? I'd quite like to equip the shield again at this point. I don't know if I can really stop, I'm not that quick. Sword, 23 gold, some quartz wax. Another one. Another skeleton over there, look. We're going to do him in as well. How much experience I'm actually getting from these? 53. I'm in the 800 away now. Yeah, you can run. Shield, while I think about it. Another one. About 53 as well. Yes. I'm tempted to actually stay here. Kill another, what, 15 skeletons. Level up. Oh, there's one. I've got the bonus of stillness now. So, individual enemies, it does work quite well. When you've got a whole horde of them, you tend to take too much damage. Any more for any more? Normally some resources knocking around in these. In these things. Off some of that. We'll see if we can finish inside an hour. Oh, there's some copper over there, I see. Stand out quite well, the copper, doesn't it? I don't know if it'll always be that colour. I think I might milk this one now. Let's see if we can escape. We'll just run one direction for a long while. I suppose we'll get out. There we go. So that's my second random encounter. This hour. I think they have improved the whole model of it. Our model of it is much better than what it was. Oh yeah, which direction am I facing? That's West Hollow. So let's go down this road. Oh, another one. Prepare to defend myself. So all I want to do is get to Househead and then I'll log off. Yeah, I haven't proved it. It's still a bit annoying if you're just trying to get somewhere. Alright, no skeletons because I killed them all. Is that right? I don't see any skeletons, so let's run through it straight through this time and see what happens. Maybe I'll come out at a different location on the road. Yeah, I did have the other night. Basically, I was trying to walk down one bit of road, and every time I walk across it, it was like this, in fact. Every time I walk across that one bit of road, there was nothing I can do. So I've killed all the skeletons. So there's really nothing to do. But it keeps dropping me into the same random encounter. Which, you know, some might say means that's not really very random then, is it? You know, on the one hand, they're an excellent opportunity to gain XP and gold. On the other hand, it's quite annoying. No, it just keeps happening. Oh, don't go off the road. Alright, we're on the King's Road now. I don't want to enter it. I want to get up to Owl's Head, where tomorrow I can resume my quest for my Christmassy hat and have it all uploaded in plenty of time for Christmas. Owl's Head. So I'm going to enter here and resume tomorrow inside Owl's Head.